iPad Mini 2021. The iPad Mini has been a long-time favorite among fans, and after a period devoid of meaningful updates, the small-screen tablet has finally got the love and attention it deserves. Sporting a reinvigorated design similar to that of the rest of the premium iPad collection, and performance to match, the 6th-gen iPad Mini is better looking and more capable than ever. The catch? There's a new price tag to reflect the upgraded smarts on offer. The question is the 6th-gen iPad Mini worth the £479 asking price? Keep reading to find out. A fresh design similar to the iPad Air. Increased display size without an increased footprint. USB-C and Touch ID. 2nd-gen Apple Pencil support, but no magic keyboard. The iPad Mini 6 is the redesign of Apple's small-screen tablet that fans have been waiting for, bringing the design more in line with that of the iPad Air 4 and iPad Pro range. In fact, it's so similar to the iPad Air that it could have been called the iPad Air Mini, if that wasn't such a mouthful, sporting the same near bezel-free look, Touch ID-enabled power button and more, though there are a few crucial differences. More on those in a bit. The key design change is a larger display, jumping from 7.9 inches on the iPad Mini 5 to 8.3 inches on the iPad Mini 6, but thanks to the slimmer bezels, it measures in at a near identical 195.4x134.8x6.3mm. That means the iPad Mini is just as dinky and portable as it was before, but with a much improved display experience. Combined with a weight of just 293 grams, it's the only iPad that you can comfortably use one-handed. While I love the big display of the 458 grams iPad Air and 682 grams iPad Pro 12.9 inches, there's something refreshing about having a one-handed tablet experience. Plus, the ability to carry it around in a large pocket is also a big win for portability. The iPad Mini is also available in a variety of new colors including pink, starlight, space gray and the purple of our review unit. While it looks beautifully purple in Apple's renders, the finish is more muted in real life, not looking that dissimilar to the space gray model in some lighting conditions. That said, the English lavender folio case, sold separately, does help the color pop. Regardless of color option, you'll find stereo speakers at the top and bottom of the iPad Mini, providing a stereo experience that'll adjust depending on the orientation of the tablet with a surprising amount of power, accompanied by the Touch ID-enabled power button and volume buttons on the top and a USB-C port on the bottom. It's the first time the volume buttons have appeared on the top of an iPad, and while it initially took a bit of adjustment, I now prefer the convenience of having all the buttons in one place. Why move the volume buttons at all? It was to make way for 2nd-gen Apple Pencil support, bringing the upgraded stylus experience to the small-screen tablet for the first time, including magnetic wireless charging. The small dimensions of the tablet meant that, unlike the iPad Air and its ample space at the side, the volume keys would get in the way of the Apple Pencil when docked. The 2nd-gen Apple Pencil is a joy to use on the iPad Mini, whether you're jotting down notes using Quick Notes, while working on a project or cooking up your next creative vision in Procreate, with impressively low latency, accurate pressure and angle detection and a no-fuss charging system. Though the new Apple Pencil experience is a welcome change for iPad Mini users, it doesn't get the equally impressive Magic Keyboard experience, despite the accessory being available for the iPad Air. It's down to a lack of smart connector on the rear of the iPad Mini, meaning you're relegated to standard iPad Mini keyboards. That's not necessarily a bad thing, with great third-party keyboard cases available, but it won't provide the same premium experience as Apple's official accessory. Packing a larger display with thinner bezels than its predecessor, the 8.3 inches LED IPS display of the 6th-gen iPad Mini is phenomenal for a tablet of its size. The visuals produced are vivid and crisp, whether you're catching up on Marvel's What If, on Disney Plus or doodling on Procreate, with respectable brightness that allows for outdoor use, albeit with reflections, up to 518 candelas M2 in benchmark tests. Colors pop with impressive vibrancy, so much so that I almost forgot that it's not actually an OLED or mini LED powering the experience, with only the not quite deep blacks giving the game away. Still, it's detailed. More detailed, in fact, than any other iPad in Apple's product line, and that includes the iPad Pro, thanks to its miniature size. The combination of an 8.3 inches display and an impressive 2266x1488 resolution provides a pixel density of 326 pi, far surpassing the 264 pi standard across the rest of the iPad collection, as well as smoking most of the Android competition too. Yes, the 179 pi Samsung Galaxy Tab A7 Lite. I'm looking at you. If you're a self-confessed pixel chaser, the high pixel density of the iPad Mini 6 will likely appeal to you. But while it's sharper than its siblings, the small display does have its downsides, namely when it comes to multitasking. Despite its tiny size, there's flagship-level performance on offer from the 6th-gen iPad Mini. At its heart you'll find the same A15 Bionic chipset as the latest iPhone range, comprised of a 6-core CPU, 5-core GPU and 16-core neural engine, and it's safe to say that it offers a lot of power. In real-world use, the iPad mini could handle anything I threw at it, be it playing Genshin Impact on the highest settings with a floating Twitter window playing a viral video, not something many people would do, but you know, testing, or throwing together a 4K edit in a movie, without a hint of stutter or lag. Even exporting the finished 4K masterpiece was a snappy process, perfect for creatives that want to share their artistic vision on the go, although the M1 on offer from the 12.9 inches iPad Pro will likely serve you better. That experience is backed up by benchmark results too, blowing the iPad Air 4 and practically every Android tablet out of the water. The iPad mini scored a respectable multi-core score of 4476 in Geekbench 5 and topped out most of the charts in Geekbench 2, making it a capable tablet for both work and play. In fact, I'm confident that the iPad mini could have pushed the frame rates even further if the refresh rate technology allowed it.